God says in Psalms 118, chapter 8, verse, it is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. And that is so true, because it is better to trust in the Lord now than to put confidence in men, because man can and will sometimes let you down. Sometimes when people let you down, it may be intentional, but that is not the case all the time. But sometimes it is the case, because it is intentional sometimes. You see, some people know that they can help you, but nevertheless, they won't help. It could be that maybe they have fear that they are being used, or they don't have natural affection to help their fellow man. Or, you know, it could be that only certain people they help out. But that is not the case all of the time with everybody, because whether some people want to help you or not, sometimes they are just not able to do it. They are just unable. And though you may have confidence in some people, and it just may be that they do come through for you, and even if they do come through for you, always remember this, that it is better to put trust in the Lord than to put your trust and confidence in men. Let's go back to the Word of God. Psalms 146, chapter the 3rd to the 10th verses says, put not your trust in princes, nor in the son of man, in whom there is no help. His breath goeth forth, he returneth to his earth, in that very day his thoughts perish. Happy is he that hath the God of Jacob for his help, whose hope is in the Lord his God, which made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that therein is, which keepeth truth forever, which executed judgment for the oppressed, which giveth food to the hungry. The Lord looseth the prisoners. The Lord openeth the eyes of the blind. The Lord raiseth them that are bowed down. The Lord loveth the righteous. The Lord preserveth the strangers. He relieveth the fatherless and widow. But the way of the wicked he turneth upside down. The Lord shall reign forever, even thy God, O Zion, unto all generations. Praise ye the Lord. You see, it is a blessing to put your trust in God and not men, because man is going to pass away, but God shall reign forever and ever. And you see, whatever you need to realize that my God got it. If you need salvation out there on today, God is able to save your soul. If you need deliverance, God is able to deliver you from drugs and alcohol. He's able to deliver you from depression and stress and all kinds of habits. And he's able to deliver you from any bad situation that you may be in. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. If you need healing, hallelujah. Ooh, thank you, Jesus. God is able to heal your body from any sickness and disease. He's also able to heal a sin sick soul. Did you hear that? God is able to heal a sin sick soul. If you need a friend, now I'm talking about a true friend. Hallelujah. Woo, thank you, Jesus. God would be a friend that you can tell anything to, and you won't have to worry about him spreading your business all over town. Even if you need your finances blessed, God can bless your finances. God is able. God can bless your finances. You can put your trust in God. Tell him what you need and what you want, for he is able to bless your finances. And if you need love, hallelujah, if you need love and joy and peace, peace of mind. If you need peace of mind, if you need a new heart and a new man in Christ Jesus, God's got it. Oh, yes, he does. He got everything that you need. Oh, if you will just Put your trust in God and not man, and receive his blessings. You will be so glad that you did. Micah, the 7th chapter, the 5th through the 8th verses says, trust ye not in a friend. Put ye not confidence in a guide. Keep the doors of thy mouth from her that lieth in thy bosom. For the son dishonoreth the father, the daughter rises up against her mother, the daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. A man's enemies are the men of his own house. Therefore, I will look unto the Lord. I will wait for the God of my salvation. My God will hear me. Rejoice not against me, O my enemy. When I fall, I shall arise. When I sit in darkness, the Lord shall be a light unto me. Did you hear what that 8th verse said? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let me read it again. That 8th verse, Micah, the 7th chapter, I read from the 5th through the 8th verses, but I want to reread that 8th verse. It says, rejoice not against me, O my enemy, when I fall. I shall arise. When I sit in darkness, the Lord shall be a light unto me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You can say what you want to say about me. I am going to continue to praise the Lord and trust in the God of my salvation. And you know what? You should put your trust in God also and not in men, because mama can help you like God can. Your sisters and your brothers cannot help you like God can. Your pastor cannot help you like God can. Your children, they can't help you like God can. Your friends, they can't do it either. Not like God can. And the leaders cannot help you like God can. Can nobody help you as good as God can? Oh, no, they can't. But if you would just look unto the Lord and wait on God, he will work it out for you. Oh, yes, he will. And my last scripture is Nahum, the 1st chapter and the 7th verse. It says, the Lord is good, a stronghold in a day of trouble, and he knoweth them that trust in him. You know, you don't have to be afraid to trust in the Lord. Oh, no, you don't. For the Lord, he is good, and a stronghold in a day of trouble. He sees. Oh, yes, he does. Oh, yes, the Lord does. He sees and knows all about your trouble. Yes, he does. So if you put your trust in God and not in man, God knows, for he knows them that trust in him.